Have you ever observed the TV remote used in your home? These TV remotes make use of certain circuits which are capable of generating frequencies or alternating signals by making use of DC source. You might have observed that cells are being used in your remote controls. By drawing the DC power from the cells, these circuits convert that DC power into the AC signals. Not only TV remote, there are other devices such as TV transmitters, TV receivers, radio transmitters. These devices make use of certain circuits which are capable of drawing the power from the DC source and convert that power into the AC, alternating current frequency, AC frequency. That kind of circuits are known as oscillators. In this session, let us learn about oscillators. Now, I start discussing about new chapter called oscillators. I'll define what is meant by oscillator. Before defining oscillator, let us know what is meant by oscillation. And after defining oscillator, let us learn about types of oscillators. After learning the types of oscillator, let us know what is meant by damped oscillation and what is meant by undamped oscillation. After that, in the later part, let us study the basic principle of oscillation, and also let us derive an expression for the voltage gain of the oscillator. What is meant by oscillations? You have seen, you have studied about oscillation in the physics during the first POC. But they are physical oscillations or mechanical oscillations. Here, let us study about electrical oscillations. What is electrical oscillations? Electrical oscillation is a periodic variation of, electric quantity alternatingly. Such a variation of electrical quantities is known as oscillation. What are those electrical quantities? Voltage, variation of voltage periodically and alternatingly. Becomes an AC signal, alternating current signal. Such a signal is known as oscillation. That is a good example for electrical oscillation. Now, what is meant by oscillators? Oscillator is a circuit which generate electrical oscillation, but for the examination purpose, we need to write the different another definition for oscillator. What we need to write? Oscillator is a circuit which converts DC energy into AC energy of desired frequency. We must write this definition. So, yen definition varibekagutte? So, oscillator is a circuit which converts DC energy into AC energy of desired frequency. This is the actual definition of oscillator. Oscillator is a circuit. Now, oscillator can be classified into two ways. They can be classified based on varieties of criteria. Oscillators can be classified based on the waveform which they generate, and oscillators can also be classified based on the components used in that. If we classify oscillator based on the waveform which it generates, we can classify oscillator into two categories. One is sinusoidal oscillator. The other one is non-sinusoidal oscillator. So, first one is First one is sinusoidal oscillator. Sinusoidal sinusoidal oscillator. Second one is non-sinusoidal. So these are the categories of oscillators which are classified on the basis of types of waveforms which they generate. If we classify oscillators based on the components used in the construction of oscillator, we can classify it them into three categories. Among them, first one is LC oscillator. Second one is RC oscillator. Last one is crystal oscillator. Crystal oscillator. Crystal oscillator. Based on the type of waveform which it produces, we can classify oscillator into two categories, that they are sinusoidal oscillators and non-sinusoidal oscillators. Based on the components being used in the construction of oscillator, we can classify oscillators into three categories, that is LC oscillators, RC oscillators and crystal oscillators. Now let us start our discussion with the sinusoidal oscillators. In this session, let us discuss only about these two. In the coming session, in upcoming session, we study about LC oscillator, RC oscillator and crystal oscillators in detail. Let us restrict ourselves to these two concepts in this session. Let us see what is meant by sinusoidal oscillators. Sinusoidal oscillators are also known as harmonic oscillators because its output function is harmonic function. Why do we call it as sinusoidal oscillator? Because this circuit generates the output waveform which is in the sinusoidal shape, which generates the waveform in the sinusoidal shape. Therefore, we call this oscillator is a sinusoidal oscillator. There are other type of oscillators which generates waveform. They may be either in the form of square wave or in the form of triangular wave or in the form of rectangular wave, or they may be spike waveforms. That kind of oscillators are known as non-sinusoidal oscillators. Non-sinusoidal oscillators generates the non-sinusoidal waveforms such as square waves, rectangular waves, triangular waves, spike waves and etc. Whereas sinusoidal waves generates the oscillations which are sinusoidal in shape, or sinusoidal oscillates generates harmonic functions. Harmonic atharanu neevu define maadkobahudu. Let us see, before getting into the basic principle of oscillators, let us study about what is meant by damped oscillation and what is meant by undamped oscillation. Let me start with, there are two kinds of oscillations. One is damped oscillation, the other one is undamped oscillations. Let us see what is meant by damped oscillation first. The electrical oscillations whose amplitude keeps on decreasing with respect to time, but its frequency remains constant. Such a oscillation is known as damped oscillation. The oscillation whose frequency whose amplitude keeps on decreasing continuously with respect to time and its frequency remains constant, such a oscillation is referred to as damped oscillation. Let us see a sinusoidal damped oscillations, how a sinusoidal damped oscillations looks like. Here, let me represent time here and let me represent voltage or amplitude here. A sinusoidal damped oscillations looks like this. You can observe that the amplitude of this frequency keep on decreasing with respect to time continuously, but its frequency remained constant. Such an oscillation is referred to as damped oscillation. Let us see what is meant by undamped oscillation. What is meant by undamped oscillation? These are the oscillations whose amplitude remains constant with respect to time and also frequency. Such oscillations are referred to as undamped oscillations. Let me represent undamped sinusoidal oscillation graphically. See, this is a graphical representation of undamped oscillation. With respect to time, its amplitude is remained constant and also frequency. Frequency is also constant, amplitude is also constant. Such a oscillation is referred to as undamped oscillation. Now, let us study the basic principles of oscillators. In the basic principles of oscillator, first we derive an expression for the voltage gain of the oscillator, and after that we study the stabilization of oscillations. After that we study the startup of oscillation and startup conditions. All these three comes in the basic principles of oscillations concept, oscillator concept. But in this session we restrict ourselves to the derivation of voltage gain of oscillators and stabilization of oscillations. We restrict ourselves to these concepts. In the next session, we start our discussion from the concept of starting up of oscillation and starting up conditions. Now, let us derive expression for voltage gain of oscillator. While studying the feedback in amplifier concept, I told that in case of amplifiers, we use negative feedback. Whereas, if we use positive feedback in an amplifier circuit, then that amplifier becomes oscillator. I already told that while studying feedback in amplifier concept. Once again, I am telling that if any basic amplifier which make use of positive feedback network, then that amplifier becomes the oscillator. Therefore, oscillator can also be defined as it can also be defined as the amplifier with positive feedback. If anybody asks you what is meant by an oscillator, you can also define it as amplifier with positive feedback. Aa tarana navu adana define madabodu. Amplifier nen anta helabodu andre oscillator na oscillator anta andre idu positive feedback amplifier antanu helabodu. Godaitala irli. Let us see why do we call it as positive feedback amplifier. Let us derive an expression for the gain of the oscillator. Here let me draw a block diagram this is the block which represents the basic amplifier circuit. Basic basic amplifier circuit means it does not contain any feedback network. It contains only input terminal and output terminal and other amplifying circuitry. Apart from that, no feedback network is used in this circuit. Now let us connect a positive feedback to this circuit. Idukondu positive feedback na naavu connect maartta hogana. This is a mixer block. These two are mixer blocks. This is a sampling circuit and this is a mixing circuit. And this is a feedback network. Feedback network. Output VO, and this is input VI, input signal. This is source signal VS. This is source signal VS. This is input signal VI. This is output signal VO. And this is feedback voltage VF. VF is equal to beta V naught. Beta V naught. This is a feedback network. This is mixer and this is separator or sampler. Mixer. This is the block diagram of positive feedback amplifier. Let me write one more thing here. 0 degree phase shift. 0 degree phase shift. That means in case of negative feedback amplifier, there will be a phase shift between this source signal and the feedback signal. There will be a phase shift. But in case of oscillator or positive feedback amplifier, there will not be any phase shift. There will not be any phase shift between input signal and the feedback signal. Input signal and feedback signal will be in same phase. Therefore, here we are writing that 0 degree phase shift. That means there will not be any phase shift in this overall circuit. There will not be any phase shift between the feedback signal and the input signal. Okay, yes, we know that the open loop gain means this is a basic amplifier. Gain of this basic amplifier is represented by A, or we also call it as open loop gain. A is equal to V naught divided by VI. This V naught divided by VI is the open loop gain. That is the open loop gain. So let me call it as equation 1. Let me call it as equation 1. And after connecting the feedback, the overall gain becomes AF. This AF is V naught divided by VS. V naught divided by VS. Let me call it as equation 2. So V naught divided by VS is the overall gain after connecting the feedback. Let me call this equation as equation 2. Idana equation 2 anta nanu karkoltini. Now, since this is a positive feedback amplifier, here Vi is equal to Vs plus Vf. So this is equation 3. See here, since it is a positive feedback amplifier, Vi is the sum of source voltage and the feedback voltage. And feedback voltage, here feedback voltage Vf is equal to beta V naught. Let it be equation 4. I can substitute equation 4 in equation 3. In place of Vf, I can write it as beta V naught. Therefore, Vi is equal to Vs plus beta V naught. I can equate this equation to Vs. Then this equation becomes Vs is equal to Vi minus beta V naught. Now, let me call it as equation 5. I can substitute this equation 5 in equation 2. 5 in 2. Then equation 2 becomes AF is equal to V naught divided by, in place of Vs, I write Vi minus beta V naught. Vi minus beta V naught. Now, I'll divide numerator and denominator by Vi. So, AF is equal to V naught divided by Vi. Here, Vi minus beta V naught whole divided by Vi. Now this becomes AF is equal to V naught by Vi, means by equation 1 I can write V naught by Vi as A. And here Vi gets cancelled, or Vi divided by Vi minus beta V naught divided by Vi. So here Vi gets cancelled and V naught divided by Vi once again becomes A. Therefore, finally I got the expression AF is equal to A divided by 1 minus A beta. So this is the expression for voltage gain of the positive feedback amplifier, or this is the expression for the gain of the oscillator. This is the expression for the gain of the oscillator. Okay. Now, let us study about the stabilization of oscillations. How do we get the stable oscillations? Why do we get the stable oscillations? Let me erase all these things and I'll keep this expression as it is. AF is equal to one minus A beta. This is the expression for the voltage gain of the amplifier. Okay. There are certain conditions for an amplifier to become an oscillator. If an amplifier satisfies certain conditions, then that amplifier becomes the oscillator. One among that condition is this A beta, loop gain A beta should be equal to 1. Loop gain A beta should be equal to 1. If this loop gain A beta becomes 1, then what happens here? AF is equal to A divided by 1 minus 1, that is 0. A divided by 0, which becomes infinity. That means gain of the amplifier becomes infinity. That means for an amplifier, we must provide certain input for amplification. We must provide AC input for amplification. But if the voltage gain of amplifier is infinity, that means without any input, that provides the output. So this is the basic principle of amplifier. This is the basic principle of oscillator. And this is the condition for stable oscillations. Look at here. Overall gain is infinity. Infinity means gain is the ratio of output divided by input. Okay, output divided by input. So if input is zero, then only we'll get the infinite gain. Here we got the infinite gain. That means we have not given any input. Even after that, we are getting the output. Therefore, we can say that even in the absence of input, this circuit is capable of giving certain output, the certain AC output or frequency. How it is possible? Because this circuit is drawing the DC power. It is drawing the DC power and converting it into a desired signal of a certain frequency, a signal of desired frequency. So, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಡಿಸಿ ಪವರ್ನ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಒಂದು ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿನ ಇದು ಜನರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸಿ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಎ ಸಿ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಸೈರ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಎ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಫೀಡ್ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್. ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಫೀಡ್ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈಯರ್ ಏನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್, ದಟ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್, ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ಟನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಯಾವ ಥರ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ಟು, ಆಲ್ಟರ್ನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ಟನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್.